So, these are going to be my thoughts on the ultrawide monitor concept. At least on the most commonly sized ultrawide, which are the 29-inch and the 34-inch models. Hopefully I get some useful information to you guys in case you're deciding between those two sizes. Or, for example, even too little, a bit smaller, way cheaper 27-inch monitors. Because why would someone ever buy a computer monitor for 800 euros? I've been watching a lot of videos on ultrawide monitors in the past year and doing quite a bit of research in figuring out if 29 inches with around 200 euros is really a good enough size. Or do I really have to fork over at least 400 euros on a 34-inch ultrawide monitor? So, for context, I did use my 150 euro 27-inch monitor for over a year a bit. And after that, I decided to buy the 29-inch and see how it goes from there. The minute I took out the 29-inch monitor from the box for the first time, I immediately felt that this is not quite it, even before I turned it on. It didn't quite feel that this is gonna upgrade my experience nor my workflow that much. And trying it out for a week, I can say it is still better than my old 27-inch monitor, but barely. It helps with the tabs, it helps with video editing because I have more space to work with, but I would say that if you have a 27-inch monitor on your desk right now, then this will feel barely like an upgrade. This thing, on the other hand, is insane. Bringing this thing into the office is a whole nother level. The box itself is humongous and heavy. Sitting in front of this thing is not even like sitting at a computer. It's more like sitting at a battle station or a command station. I will talk about the curve in a little bit, but the sheer size of this thing is big enough to redeem some kind of a "that's what she said" comment out of every person's mouth that has been sitting in front of this thing so far. From a productivity standpoint, I can put, for example, 4 Word documents with 130% text size with side by side by side by side. And for my fellow tab monsters out there, you can have 50 tabs open and still can see previews, what is in them. 50 tabs. Okay, yeah, a lot of websites gonna look pretty weird and lonely in the sea of blank space, but others that have a dynamic site can display a lot and can make your workflow way quicker and way more effective. I personally don't game basically at all and don't watch movies in my office chair that much, but for the people that do, this is one hell of an experience. The curve. Okay, from the side it looks insane and awesome. Sitting in front of it, you will not notice the curve in a couple of hours, honestly. I personally don't see a huge value from the curve. It certainly looks awesome, but I really can't justify it for around 300 euros. Maybe 400, but not 300 euros. Because that's how much they charge you for compared to a flat screen, which is currently itself 400 euros. So, if you followed along, then you figured out already that the 34-inch curved starts at 700 euros. This Dell U3415W is around 800 euros currently. I brought mine used and paid way less, but still, this thing has been the second most expensive tech I have ever bought. Okay, aside from the price for a moment here, if you really need screen real estate and you can live with bezels, you can get 2 27-inch monitors for around 300-400 euros and have actually way more screen real estate even compared to this thing. So, in conclusion, I love this monitor very much. Is it overkill? Yes. Do you have to get 34 inches over 29 inches? Yes. Do you have to care about the curve? No. Can you make a lot of "that's what she said" jokes when people see this monitor on your desk? Oh yes. Thank you for watching and subscribe and see you on the next one.